Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a privilege again it is for us to be in the presence of the Lord on the vFamily Church. Hallelujah. We are streaming from Trinidad and Tobago. And we are so pleased that you can join us for this week's service. Praise God. Hallelujah. This week we want you to fight. Fight. We are in a battle. Everything around us is tumultuous. And we are, you know, the Bible said that we must fight the good fight. And this week we have a minister who will tell you how to fight and what we have to fight for. Hallelujah. Praise God. But before we go into the service, I just want to open in a word of prayer. Hallelujah. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, God, for the privilege you have bestowed upon us to worship you, to be in your presence. Hallelujah. We want to thank you, God, for life and health and strength. Oh, God, we do not take it for granted, God, that we are here in the land of the living. Oh, God, many, God, die on a daily basis. Many, God, are subdued, God. And we, oh, God, we thank you, God, that you have seen it fit, God, that we are here. And Father God, we pray, God, as we go through this service, God, that some heart or some mind, oh God, will be touched, God, by what is presented here. Father God, you told us in your word, God, that you will never leave us nor forsake us. And we thank you, God, that you have never left us and you will never forsake us. Oh God, you are a man who will not lie, God. You keep your promises, for your promises are yea. And they are amen. So God, we want to thank you, God, that you are a promise keeper. You are a way maker, God. And we bless your holy name. Hallelujah. Praise God. We want to thank you, Jesus, God. Holy Spirit, rule and reign in our service. Rule and reign in the midst of our homes. Rule and reign wherever, God, we are viewing this service. And God, we want to bless your name. We hallow your name, Jesus. We adore you, Lord God. We worship you, Father. For you are worthy, God, to be praised. You are worthy, God, to be lifted up, God. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. For those of us who are those who like boxing, and we are those in the red corner and the man in the blue corner, and you know, persons are there and we are boxing, and even when we have the opponent in sometimes in under restraint, sometimes we look at at them and we say, yeah, we are keeping them locked. But today we want to tell you that there is a fight that is going on, a fight that does not need a hand, a fight, a spiritual fight. And God would have equipped us with the tools wherewith, God, we will use those tools for that spiritual battle that we will engage in. Hallelujah. So before, we just want to welcome our worship team who will lead us into a time of worship. Praise God.
Hallelujah. God, we give you praise. Wow. see. Lift the scales from my eyes, I can see. Oh Yahweh, you're so holy.
Come on, you know the song, come on.
You have helped me in my story.
Somebody bless his name with me. Hallelujah. Yeah, yeah. Oh. We declare again, not by might. Come on.
Not by power, but the Spirit.
They may come. You gotta testify.
But my strength,
hey,
has become my song.
By your power, hey,
you parted the sea. Lift the scales from my eyes, I can see. Yeah. Oh Yahweh,
come on.
Mighty King.
Hello, everyone. My name is Devon Musgrave, and I play drums for Tunapuno Open Bible, and it has been a really great honor and blessing, you know, to serve there. And what I want to talk about is actually the importance of timing and more so God's timing. I tend to realize cycles in my life, and I think it's important as well that as believers we realize cycles, whether it's good or negative cycles. And I felt strongly like June was going to be a new season. Since actually November, I've been feeling that way. And you know, sometimes when you feel like, you know, maybe God's showing you something, you could start to either overthink as opposed to looking at what is in front of you and ensuring that, you know, you're just walking in obedience with God. And so the job I have, or had, and I'll say that, is a job that is based in America. And I would say it has been a blessing for me, you know, to serve and do real estate from Trinidad, even though the job is in America. And that in itself was a testimony. But I started feeling like, you know, I was getting to a place where the desire to be, you know, married and to acquire certain things, you know, it felt kind of far from me. But at the same time, I was feeling like in this season, I kept on hearing the word acceleration. You know, I kept on hearing the word like, trust me. And even though sometimes it didn't look like that physically, I was choosing to trust God. And between November to May, month end, it was testing after testing. It was sometimes things that looked absolutely hopeless. And what I like to say is God's timing is really the best. I mean, we always hear it in church, we hear it from everyone. But it worked so much in a way that I decided to do a fast in the month of May for 21 days specifically, because I felt like there were certain cycles in my life that needed to end. And I felt like immediately after that cycle, after that fast, God is going to do something tremendous. I didn't want to be like those preachers who just declaring, God is going to do this, God is doing that, God is doing that. But you're not being faithful to God, you know, you're not serving God, you're not sowing, you know, you're not giving. And so within that fast, I started giving people things. I started doing things that were just out of the ordinary, you know, for me. Like just giving people money, blessing people, showing my parents love in the way that they receive love. You know, things that just revolved around me giving person as opposed to me just getting what I wanted immediately. So much so that exactly the day right after my fast, I got a call, you know, from a job that I couldn't even remember applying for. And they asked like, hey, Devon, you still interested in this accounting executive position? I'm like, yeah. And the person said the name of the company so fast, I didn't catch what they said. But all they wanted was to have an interview with me the next day. And the way how they approached me and they spoke to me is almost like they wanted me to have the job without me even saying anything about myself, which in itself is a testimony because I've been sending out resumes for an entire year while at that job. And I either haven't been getting calls or when I went to the interview, it wasn't as, you know, successful as I would have imagined. And just one day after the fast, I got a call. And then the day after was the interview. And I'm telling you, I was in tears immediately after that interview. And here's why. The guy was sounding more like he was convincing me of why this job was for me, which was crazy. He was saying, well, Devon, you know, I'm looking at your resume and you just seem like the man for the job. And what he said was, first of all, the money was wow. The fact that I got to work remotely was a blessing. And the fact that, you know, he was just very confident that I could do the job as well just made me say that this is an answer to the prayer I was praying even within the fast. And I'm saying all that to say that God's timing is so perfect that he pays attention to the biggest things and even the details. So much so that the job where I worked at right now requires me to give a 1 month notice. Had I given my job a 1 month notice, I was so worried about the fact that they may not pay me for the entire thing. And again, I've been working at this job for a month and a year. And imagine that last week, they gave me a 1 month notice that my contract is ending, the job where I'm at. And they said they will give me full pay. So now I get full pay from the job where I'm at, and I get to leave in under a month to go immediately into this new job. And I think that in itself is just amazing how God's timing works. So I just want to encourage you to trust God, because it might seem sometimes like a fairy tale, but there is nothing greater than trusting God and walking in obedience with him. because he will grant you your heart's desires as long as it is in accordance with his will for your life. Thank you. Lord.
Hallelujah. Continuously on our side. Hallelujah. We have nothing to fear. Hallelujah. That's like a war cry. Come on. We declare God is fighting for us. God is on our side. We have overcome, yes, we have overcome. We will not be shaken, we will not be moved. Jesus, you are here, carrying our burden, covering our shame. We have overcome, yes, we have overcome. We will not be shaken, we will not be moved. So we declare, I will live, I will not die.
Resurrection,
power of Christ, and I am free in Jesus' name. Come on, put your hands together, right where you are. Hey, come on, somebody. Come on. Can we sing it again? God is fighting for us. God is on our side. We will. Hey, come on. Come on, somebody. We will not be shaken. Jesus, you are here. So we say, I will live. I will not die. The resurrection. I will live, I will not die.
I will be
and lift you high. Christ revealed, and I am healed in Jesus' name. Do you agree? If you agree, if you agree, clap your hands like this. Come on. If you need to stomp your feet and clap your hands, you better get moving. Hey, hey, as we say, fighting for us, pushing back the darkness, lighting up the kingdom that cannot be shaken. Enemies defeated, and we will shout it out. Come on, let's go. God is fighting for us, pushing back. And we will shout it out. One more time, say, God is fighting for us, pushing back the
lighting up the
kingdom. Yeah, yeah. My God. And we will shout it out. I will live. I will live. I will not die.
Resurrection.
God, and more time. One more time. Come on, let's go. God is fighting for us. Pushing man up. Lighting up the kingdom. Woo! Hey! We will. And we will shout it out.
Wow, such a powerful time. Hallelujah. We are ushered into the presence of God through worship. We are ushered into the presence of God through praise. When we praise and when we worship, hallelujah, we feel and we will experience the presence of God. Praise God. We want to thank our worship ministers who so diligently and, you know, lead us into that time. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Brother Musgrave, reminding us that God is our provider. And sometimes when we think that we are forgotten, sometimes when we think that, you know, our ways are clouded, our ways are clogged, hallelujah, we just have to remember that we serve a God who can unclog everything that has been stuck. Hallelujah. We can rest assured, hallelujah, that God is able, hallelujah, to do what he says he will do. Because we serve a God, hallelujah, who can do exceedingly abundantly above all that we could ever ask or think. Hallelujah. So we want to thank God for his greatness and his goodness. Hallelujah. Praise God. At this time, we are going to go into the Word of God. We have a powerful young minister, a soldier by profession, Minister Levi Collins, who will take us into God's Word this week.
2 Timothy 2 and verse 3 exhorts us to endure hardship as a good soldier. And in order to endure hardship or afflictions, we ought to train like a soldier. However, soldiers don't just train to endure tough times, but to fight. Soldiers are trained to kill. They are trained to engage the enemy and neutralize them. Every believer that had made Jesus Christ as their Lord and Savior has entered into a fight against the forces of darkness, a fight that can be seen physically, but is deeply rooted in the spirit. And so many of us fight from a place where we can see and allow the enemy to gain grounds in our lives, to gain territory because of ignorance. The Bible says in Ephesians 6 that we wrestle not against flesh and blood. The word wrestle means to contend, to do battle, to do close combat, but not against flesh and blood. The Amplified Bible says, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood. We are not contending only with physical opponents, but against rulers, against powers, against the forces of this present darkness, against spiritual forces of wickedness in heavenly or supernatural places. And so we must understand that we are in a supernatural war, a spiritual fight. And so because this fight is spiritual, we need spiritual weapons. As a soldier, before we engage the enemy, before we go to battle, we must study the enemy's arsenal, what he is capable of before we attack. The Bible says that we are not ignorant of the enemy's devices, and so too must we not be ignorant of the weapons that are made available to us to fight. 2 Corinthians 10 and verse 4 says, "For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal, but they are mighty through God to the pulling down of strongholds, casting down imagination and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, and bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ." As a soldier of God, you cannot fight principalities and powers, arguments, imagination, and mindsets with guns and with bombs and with knives. You can go to China and learn Kung Fu, Tai Chi, Karate, Wusu, Wing Chun, or whatever it might be. Nothing of those sorts is effective in the spiritual realm. According to Colossians 2, Jesus disarmed principalities and powers and make an open show of them and had armed you. Paul said, "Take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God." As a soldier, you should fight using the word of God coupled with prayer. Fight with worship. Fight with praise. Fight with your obedience to God. At all times, a soldier trusts his training, and so too we, as soldiers of the Most High God, must trust the word of God. And fight the good fight of faith as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Fight with your loins girded with truth against the lies of the enemy. Fight with the breastplate of righteousness against the unrighteousness of men. Fight ready to share the gospel of peace wherever your feet might go. Fight with the shield of faith against the deception and whatever the enemy might throw at you. Fight with the helmet of salvation, knowing that you are protected and delivered from damnation. Fight with the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, and drive it through the heart of your enemy, which is the devil. Luke 22 and verse 31 and 32 says, Jesus is speaking. He said, "Simon, Simon, Satan has desired to have you to sift you as wheat, but I have prayed for you that your faith fail not." Satan has desired to agitate Peter, to put him under trials and temptation, to see if his faith will fail in Jesus. Many of us are at this point. We are being sifted by the enemy, under trials, under temptations, afflictions. He has some of us backed up against a wall in a corner, ready to give up. However, Jesus said, "I have prayed for you." Many times, prayer don't stop the enemy's attack, but it strengthens you to endure it, to overcome it, for breakthrough. According to Daniel 9, prayer brings angelic help. It brings skill. It brings understanding. As a soldier, sometimes when you engage in warfare, the enemy might have so much suppressing fire on you, it might be difficult for you to even come out to peep to see where the enemy is at, because you're under so much attack. You just crouch yourself down and hoping that the enemy will stop at one point in time. And that is why a soldier don't go to war by himself. Prayer provides covering fire, which allows the one that is being attacked to move, to get out to safety. So too, we must cover each other in prayer. "I have prayed for you," Jesus said to Peter. "I have prayed for you." It's time to fight in prayer. Give each other covering fire. Point your weapons at the enemy and lay down suppressive fire at the enemy, so the one that has been attacked is able to move and to get out of harm's way, to get out of being attacked by the enemy. It's time to fight in prayer and give each other covering fire from the enemy. It's time for us now to lay suppressive fire, fire at the enemy so much that he himself now has to take cover. He himself now has to duck and hide. He himself now has to flee in the name of Jesus. Lay your weapons and aim it at the enemy and provide suppressing fire. Cover each other in prayer. That is what I'm trying to say. Cover each other in prayer. And so Jesus told Peter, I have prayed for you. I have covered you in prayer. Hallelujah. A soldier fights for the freedom and sovereignty of his country. So too must we fight against the plans of the enemy. Fight against the agenda that is infiltrating this land. Fight against the agenda that against the constitution of God. Fight against the agenda that are being pushed to normalize behaviors against God. Fight against the agenda to disrupt family, to create perversion in the minds of this nation. Fight against those that are influencing the minds of our children. As a soldier, put on the full armor of God and fight. Fight against gang warfare, against the spirit of murder and crime in our nation. Fight for the proper management of our resources. Fight against corruption and for the exposing of crookedness of men in high offices in the name of Jesus. Give covering fire over the Church of Jesus Christ. Fight for the leadership of the Church of Jesus Christ, that the strength of God, that the power of God, that the grace of God, that the mind of God, that the power of God, that the Spirit of God, give them strategy in this time, in the name of Jesus. Fight for your peace. Fight for your sanity. Fight for your husband. Fight for your wife. Fight for your children. Fight for your family. Fight for your health. Fight for your wealth. Fight for your ministry. Fight for your country. Fight for your brothers and sisters, especially those are the household of faith. Fight for your finances. Fight, fight, fight in the name of Jesus. Fight the good fight of faith as a good soldier of Jesus Christ. Fight.
Come on, put your hands together. The Bible says that we overcome by the blood of the Lamb and by the words of our testimony. Today we want to declare that you are anointed to put the enemy under your feet. You are anointed to walk in victory. Are you ready? Let's go.
If your hands are anointed, and if your feet are anointed, and if you're under the blood, give me a Holy Ghost shout. Say if your hands are anointed, and if your feet are anointed, and if you're under the blood, give me a Holy Ghost shout. Say if your hands are anointed, if your feet are anointed, and if you're under the blood, under the blood, under the blood, I am anointed.
Somebody say blood of Jesus. One time, we're taking it from the top. We're declaring blood over the enemy life. We're gonna take back everything that the enemy has stolen from us. Somebody say,
if your hands are anointed, and if your feet are anointed, and if you're under the blood, give me a Holy Ghost shout. Say if your hands are anointed, and if your feet are anointed, and if you're under the blood, I am anointed to put the enemy under my feet. I am anointed, moving forward, no more retreat.
I'm waging war on the enemy, taking back what was stolen from me.
I am anointed and appointed. I'm a mighty warrior in God's army. I am anointed.
Put the enemy under your feet. I am anointed. We win.
your defeat. I'm waging war on the enemy, taking back what was stolen from me. I am anointed and appointed. I'm a mighty warrior, in God's army. I'm taking back my joy, back my peace, back my health and my wealth. Everything He stole from me, everything He took from my family. I'm taking back my dance and my shout. For all the years He tried to shut my mouth, I am anointed and appointed. I'm a mighty warrior in God's army. I'm taking back my peace, back my joy, back my health and my wealth. Everything stole from me, everything He took from my family. I'm taking back my dance and my shout. For all the years He trying to hush my mouth, I am anointed and appointed. Come on! I'm a mighty warrior in God's army.
We're getting ready to go to war. I want you to put on your shoes right now. We're gonna go down to the camp of the enemy and we're gonna blood him up. Are you ready?
Blood, 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 blood,
blood him up.
Blood, 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 blood,
blood him up. Just 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 blood him up. One more time.
Blood, blood, blood.
We blood you up. We take back everything that you have stolen. Hallelujah. We take back with joy. We take back with peace. We take back with strength. We take back with healing. We take back with name. We take it back. We take it back. Oh God, just lick him down. Mash up him head. Hey, oh Jesus.
Thank you, Minister Collins. Fight the good fight. Fight the good fight. Fight. Let us put on the whole armor of God that we will be able to withstand the wiles and the cunningness of the evil one. We will be able to put on that full armor. We need to be dressed and ready. Hallelujah. For the battle. That for the battle. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. When we go down in our word, when we go into prayer, when we go into worship, we prepare ourselves. Preparation, hallelujah, is important for battle. Preparation is important, hallelujah, praise God. And when we are prepared, hallelujah, no devil in hell, hallelujah, will stop us, praise God, hallelujah. So we want to thank God for that powerful word, for Minister Collins reminding us, hallelujah, that we always have to be prepared for the battle. Hallelujah. We have to fight for our nation. We have to fight for our families, fight for our children, our young men, our young women. Hallelujah. We have to. Hallelujah. Sometimes our fighting, hallelujah, is on our knees. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We have to constantly, hallelujah, get down on the knees and, oh, cry out, hallelujah, on the name of the Most High God. Praise God. Reko. Hallelujah. Praise God. We have to fight. Hallelujah. This battle is not easy. Hallelujah. We have to be prepared. Praise God. So thank you, Minister Collins, for such powerful word. Praise God. Thank you again for joining the vFamily Church. It has indeed been a pleasure and privilege to serve you and to bring the word of God to you through worship, through testimony, and through the word of God. Hallelujah. We want to invite you to subscribe to our channel. We want to also invite you to like the video. Hallelujah. If you want to reach out to us, you can go onto our website and you can send us a message. We will get in contact with you. Hallelujah. If you need to accept the Lord, if the word would have touched you and you really want to say, I want to live for Jesus Christ, we want to give you that opportunity to serve Christ, because we know that we are in the last and closing days. Hallelujah. So we want to invite you to reach out to us on our website and we will contact you. Praise God. This is a time where we have to live for the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Because he's the only one who is able to take us through what we are going to experience. Hallelujah. Because we need a fortitude. We need a strength. Hallelujah. To endure what is going to come our way. So we want to thank God again for you. And may God richly bless your homes, bless your community, and bless your nations. Hallelujah. So we want to thank God and we bless God for you. So praise God. Do enjoy the remainder of the week and see you again next week. Praise God.